In this video, we will learn how you can access various information about the battery of the device the app is running on. So, let's start the video without wasting our time. Hey, what's going on internet? This is Vivek from TechWithVP. Your problem, our solution. Let's have some look that you will what you will learn in this video. First, you will learn how to check state of battery, either it is in a charging state or discharging state. You can also check whether your battery is fully charged or not. Second, you can check battery levels, means how many percentage your battery is charged. I'm really not sure about iOS devices and Flutter web. It may not work on iOS due to iOS security reasons. You cannot access device information on iOS devices. So check it yourself, guys, and tell me in the comment section if it is working or not. To get this information, we need to specify one dependency, which is battery, into our hopspace.yml file here. So in this video, I will use my physical device so I can show you how that state are changing when I plug or unplug charging cable into my mobile device. So let's jump into the coding section. So as I told you guys, we need to specify one dependency here, which is battery. Here I will use any, so it will download latest version of it. I would like to tell you one thing. You can check out these dependencies and their version always at pub.dev website, pub.dev, and search for battery. And click on this. This is the link where you will find this all this stuff. And here you can check that latest version. Here the latest version is battery 1.0.1. So I use any, then it will automatically download the latest version. Now our dependencies are all set. Now here I already created one blank project so we can save our time. First I create one statelet widget, then I create this stateful widget home page. And here I created one app bar with a title of app title of battery example. So let's run this example. Here our app is launched. So you can see this blank app with the title of battery. So now we will do our code. So first we will do some, we will create some objects of battery class. Now come here and create battery underscore battery is equal to battery. Let's import this dependency library. Then we will create battery state underscore battery state and leave it blank now. Then this variable is for battery levels, how many percentage of our battery is charged, and last one is stream subscription with the battery state. Here underscore battery, not stream subscription. Okay, that's good. Battery stream subscription. Okay, so here I created all the variables which are needed in this application. Now let me close this for now. Let us create init method. Override. Here super dot in Now we will use this battery state subscription so we can listen for our battery state changing event. So first what will be I will do, battery state subscription is equal to underscore battery dot, this is a guys, this is a property of it, our battery class, on battery state change. So now we can use one method of it, which is a listen. Here I will specify, not event, I will specify battery state. Now what we will do, guys, this is a state when we will plug or unplug our charging cable, and it will look for changes in our battery state, and it will tell us that this state is currently IM, on IM. So here we will use set state method to set our new state. So battery state is equal to specify this state. Now our state work is done. Now we will code for our levels, means how many percentage our battery is charged now. So for that we will create one method which will be future method, and it will not return anything, that's why we are specifying void here. It will give us error because we have a return future. Then underscore get level, which will be async. Then what we will do, we will declare one variable final in battery level is equal to await underscore battery dot battery levels. Now you can see this battery level. Now we get this battery levels, and what we will do, we will set it to this battery level. Again we will use set state method, and underscore battery levels is equal to this battery level. Now we got our battery levels too. One more step which will be dispose method, while because we are using stream, so we have to cancel it once we use it. Now again override void dispose super dot dispose, and we will check for if our battery state subscription is not null, then just cancel it dot cancel. Okay, done. So our all steps are done, just we need to print that battery state and battery levels here. For that what we will do, we will create our body here, body, and we will use column children. First we will use text, and here we will specify our state, in which state our battery is currently, underscore battery state. Okay, so we successfully get our state here. Then what we will do, so you can see currently our battery state is null because we have to restart our application. First I will do some full coding section. First we will complete our coding section, then we will look at our state and restart our application. So for one more thing is, we have to create one raise button. So when we click on that button, we will get our levels of battery. So here child text, here I will give check levels, and on press method get level, we will call this future method. We don't need to specify parentheses here. Okay, now it's done. So you can see our button is also showing here. So let me put this in center, in axis alignment center, so it all comes to center. Cross axis alignment dot center. let me grab it. Okay. So enter now. Now finally we will give one more text here, which will show us our labels. Labels dollar underscore battery label. So guys, our code is done now. So you can see in the screen that state is null and labels is null. Once we have to restart our application. So I'll just restart performing hot reload. So guys, you can see what is showing. Battery state is full. You can check on the above section, it is 100% charge. My battery is 100% charge. So it is showing us battery state dot full. And when we check label, it will showing us 100. You can specify percentage also here. Percentage. Let's check what happened. Okay, 100%. Now I'm unplugging my cable. So I unplug. You can see guys that our battery state is now discharging. And again when I plug it, it's in a charging mode, and when it comes to full, it will be 100% and it will show us battery state dot full. Let's wait for a while. So guys, you can see now battery state dot full means our phone is fully charged. So guys, this is it. This is all about your battery information, how you can check your battery state, your battery levels, how many percentage your battery is charged. I hope this information will help you with your project. So if you are new to this channel, please guys hit the subscribe button, hit the bell icon so you can get my latest videos notification direct. So thank you so much for watching. If you face any problem related to this video or any IT related problems, please feel free to comment below. I will surely help you to solve your problems. And you can check this project on my GitHub repository also. I will post it there and I will give a link into description section. So thanks for watching guys. I will see you in the next video. We'll be right back.